In April 2017, six teams of scientists from all over the world came together for the world's smallest car race. Teams had to use state-of-the-art electron microscopes to guide their cars on a track 100 times thinner than a strand of hair. And even if the distance was so small, the whole race took 30 hours. But what is the purpose of this race? And what is a nanocar?
My name is Rémi Pavlak, and I was one of the pilots of the Swiss Nano Dragster during the first international nanocar race. So the idea is to use an organic molecule that you synthesize, that you adsorb on the surface, and then you have to move the molecule. And this is what makes your molecule a car in principle. It's a race, you go to win in principle. It's a bit egocentric. You want to win. You just want to be fast, good, having a good concept of car. But at the end, you realize that, well, we are all motivated by the same. It's to show what we are actually doing. And this was quite beneficial. It's not because we are small that we are really efficient. We are actually extremely inefficient. The amount of energy we give to this molecule is lost into the surface. And here we have to think about how to actually optimize this, how to transfer correctly the energy we give, these electrons, to the molecule into the motion, because most of it is lost into the surface.
Hi, my name is Chris Wilmer, and my research group is the Hypothetical Materials Lab, and we focus on computational studies of different materials. It's my sense that designing better nanocars today is at least 50% art and 50% science, and that a lot of the science right now really just is being used in terms of how to build the nanocar and not why it should have one design versus another. So I think computational modeling, atomistic simulations, can play a huge role in helping people figure out what kind of car they should build. Yeah, I think there are a lot of technologies that when people begin working on them, their utility is not obvious. The invention of the airplane was not only met with skepticism in the form of, it can't be done, but there were countless number of people who said that it shouldn't be done or it's pointless to do. If there's some quote about, you know, if humans were meant to fly, God would have given us wings. But all that sounds so silly. And I think that, you know, in the far future where we can easily design molecular machines to do useful work for us, no one's going to question that that's silly. And something like organizing a race around a nanocar, I think, creates some focus for people to demonstrate that they can make non-arbitrary changes to small molecules to impart some simple function.